Hello there. Today I'm counting down my picks for the top 5 male romance options in Star Wars The Old Republic. We all get rather attached to our beloved Bioware companions, but some capture your heart more than the rest. This video will talk about specifics from various storylines, so a spoiler alert is in order. Eric Jorgen. You meet Eric Jorgen in the Republic Trooper storyline on the beginning planet of Ord Mantell.
I'll make this completely clear, rookie. When you're in the field, what I say goes. Period.
I can handle myself, sir.
Lieutenant Eric Jorgen is your operations officer for your mission with the Elite Havoc Squad. He's a bit of a hardhead, a professional, a proper trooper who expects the same from his fellows. When Havoc Squad defects to the Empire, Eric gets blamed and basically gets demoted to be a sergeant and has to serve under your character, who gets promoted to lieutenant.
I'd be glad to have you in the unit, Jorgen.
I'll take the Havoc patch and Sergeant Stripes if it means I get to grind them into Tavis's face before we kill him.
This is the best I can do for you, Jorgen.
This is a good romance, because he's very respectful, and he's a proper soldier. He struggles very deeply with how Command took his career away from him, and therefore works even harder to be the perfect trooper. But once you break through this tough guy act, he gets adorably awkward about it, and he doesn't want to overstep his boundary for his commanding officer.
Look, I don't know if this thing between us is going anywhere. You're a remarkable woman, but you're still my CO.
The moment that really sealed this deal for the romance, well, there's two actually. The first one was when he made the awkward proposal of becoming his life mate. Granted, you as the player can make him feel even more awkward by doing so, but it's adorable and it's sweet.
Are you asking me to be your life mate?
Blast a woman, I had all this planned out.
The other moment is of course the reunion in Knights of the Fallen Empire, Chapter 11, Disavowed, where you will recruit him back to your alliance. You hear how he struggled and how he suffered with the knowledge of you being gone. It will absolutely melt your heart.
When they declared you KIA, I fought it. I couldn't let go, they said. It almost earned me a psych discharge. As the years went by, I started to believe them. Where have you been?
Any last words?
Can that garbage, and I love you.
Felix Iresso. Your first meet with Lieutenant Felix Iresso is on Hoth, during the Jedi Consular storyline.
Hey! See guys? Just when it seems bleak, in walks a Jedi.
Felix Iresso is the ranking officer on Hoth, of the squad that was sent to fight the Whitemoor Pirates and their seemingly invincible leader, Valon. His team is losing morale and almost commits mutiny. After they succeed their mission, however, Iresso wants to join your crew instead of the reward from the Republic, which of course happens. He even used to serve with Eric Jorgen.
It'd be an honor to serve with you. Plus an extra blaster never goes amiss, right?
This is a good romance, because he's instantly infatuated with your Jedi, like Anakin and Padme. He struggles with his past in an Imperial prison and holding the knowledge of a Sith holocron in his mind. But he lives and breathes for your Jedi, and does not seem afraid that she's strong on her own. I do also acknowledge that I do get captured by Iresso due to the amazing music that is always chosen for the romance scenes. I can't help it.
Then one day we'll have a huge ceremony on Titan, or wherever you'd like, and invite everyone. But for now, take my promise. I'm yours, Barson Thor of the Jedi. Forever.
The moment that sealed the deal for this romance, just like Eric, is two very endearing moments. The first one is how he gladly shows his infatuation with a simple kiss on the cheek, along with beautiful music.
Don't give up your secrets all at once. I want to find some out for myself.
The other one is the moment where you are reunited after Knights of the Eternal Throne. He comes to Adescent scarred and damaged, again haunted by his past with the Sith holocron, but he is devoted and just wants to spend the rest of his life with your Jedi. Also, Anakin's dream is the music played for this scene. What has a girl gotta do?
Only thing that
kept me from giving up was the thought of seeing your face again. After all this, I'm not the same person you fell for.
Torian Cadera. You meet Torian for the first time in the Bounty Hunter storyline on Dromund Kaas as you become champion of the Great Hunt.
And you are?
She's more warrior than you, Jogo.
Your proper introduction to Torian happened on Terrace, however. He's hunting the same contract or target as you, his father, Jikon Cadera. Torian is doing it to claim his clan's honor, so he helps you. Then he asks to join your crew to earn back the respect for his clan.
I mean to serve, join your hunts, earn respect for my clan.
How could you say no to a face like that?
This is a good romance, because just like the TV series The Mandalorian, he is an honorable hunter. He's very straightforward and honest, and he's not scared of a strong woman just like Eresso. He's fully devoted to your hunter and to your cause. He even teaches you Mandoa.
Nikartail, Gardarasum.
This romance is also the only reason why I would ever sacrifice Vett in Knights of the Eternal Throne, Chapter 8, End Times. I can't give him up.
Mi solus tome, mi solus dar tome, mi medinuion, mi bajuri verde. I know you forever, Share.
The moment that seals the deal for this romance is his confession of love. He is so forward that how can you not find that adorable? But like the previous one, that is of course not the only moment. The very well-written reunion in Knights of the Fallen Empire, Chapter 14, Mandalore's Revenge. He is surprised to see you, but he immediately calls you his beloved. Then he even ditches the party to spend time just with you. Come on, that's too cute! Theron Shan. You meet Theron Shan on any class in the Forge Alliance storyline leading up to the Shadow of Revan.
Any relation to the Jedi Grand Master, Satil Shan?
This is why I keep asking for a codename.
Theron is the secret son of Satil Shan and Jace Malcolm, the two big Republic heroes from the cinematic trailers. He got Jedi training, but turned out to not be Force sensitive, so he turned to the SIS. Working in secret most of the time gave him great insight into numerous dangerous people, so he teams up with your character to stop the conspiracy of the Revanites.
It's him. Revan.
This almost became my number one romance option. First of all, Theron Shan is voiced by Troy Baker. He is confident, strong-willed, and he's a Shan. True enough, the romance started out with some semi-awkward flirting, but it turned serious and adorable. When he betrays you after Iokath, he is visibly crushed from doing it. He is just one of the most amazing romance options.
I love you, Theron. Come home.
I love you too. But I can't.
I'm actually not sure what particular moment sealed the deal for this romance, because I do like everything about this character. But I would say I especially adore the moment you have with him after the entire Traitor trilogy, when he fully commits to your character. He even proposes and is kind of sweet.
Will you, you know.
This is really difficult for you, isn't it?
Just marry me, please?
Before I get to the number one spot, here are some honorable mentions.
I swear to spend my life protecting your body, honoring your spirit, and respecting your mind. My first and last goal of every day will be to bring a smile to your face.
I know you don't want me turning sentimental, but I gotta say it. You are beautiful.
Are you saying you love me?
Yeah, I guess I am.
This is unfamiliar territory for me. I'm not sure how to proceed.
I would do anything
to keep you safe. Do you understand?
I feel the same way, Scourge.
Vector Hillis. Here we are. You meet Vector Hillis in the Imperial Agent storyline on the planet of Alderaan.
We are Vector Hillis, Dawn Herald of the Ouroboro Nest. Pleased to make your acquaintance, Agent.
Vector is an ambassador who was repurposed into an alliance between the Empire and the native aliens on Alderaan, the Killix, which altered him. He provides your agent with information and help from the Killix while on Alderaan. After your mission, he gets permanently transferred onto your team by the diplomatic service.
Your requisition has been made permanent. You've been officially transferred to Imperial Intelligence.
It was a tough choice between Vector and Theron, but Vector won in the end. His awkwardness, his directness, and to an extent his alienness is super endearing. He reminds me so much of Thane Krios from Mass Effect 2, both because of his alien nature, but also because he's very poetic when he speaks.
So we have to be direct. Is our relationship becoming unprofessional?
Like the previous ones, he is respectful, devoted, and just plain sweet. And those black eyes are to die for. He just makes me smile.
As have you, Agent. You always will be.
The moment that really sealed the deal for this number one romance was his willingness to disconnect from the Hive for your character's sake and have a few private moments. It was kind and respectful and very thoughtful.
Surprise.
You have nice eyes. It's good to see them.
You look different without your electric aura, but just as lovely. The Abia Nest taught me to repress the pheromonic bond.
And when you then again reunite with him after Knights of the Eternal Throne, he expresses pain and how much it affected him, how the Hive actually disconnected from him because they could not bear his pain. I just wanted to give him a hug and tell him everything would be okay. It broke my heart. He's just the kindest.
When you disappeared, the Nest limited our connection to them. They couldn't bear to experience losing you.
Vector.
Hearing your song again, it's as though we've awoken from a nightmare. We want to come home, Agent. I love you.
Your home is always with me, Vector. I never stopped loving you.
It is difficult to describe how this makes us feel.
Then maybe you should show me.
As you wish.
So what do you think? Who is your favorite male romance? Let me know in the comments down below. And if you like this video, please remember to like and subscribe. You can also catch me on my live streams on Twitch, Monday to Friday from 10 a.m. And that will be in London time. See you in the next one.